Should you use AdWords Express? Let's get into this today. I had a client who I'm doing AdWords for, and they had set up an AdWords Express account, and it was awful. If you're using AdWords Express, you're gonna want to watch this video because there's just so many pitfalls of using AdWords Express. Let's get into this. Hey there, my name is Brandon Brashears. I make daily digital marketing videos here. So if you're trying to grow your brand or your business with digital marketing, this is a great place. You can check out all the videos that I have. I talk about pay-per-click ads, email, SEO, social media marketing. Basically, if it's related to digital marketing or content creation, I talk about it here. All right, so let's get into today's video. AdWords Express is a kind of like a good idea in theory, right? It's a simple way to take brands and businesses and go into the big wide world of AdWords. So that sounds good in theory. And typically there is a super guided process, and you go in and they tell the Google what your website's about. And there are extremely guided processes where you don't even put keywords in, you just put your website URL, and then all of a sudden you are running ads and you're up for business. Now it's going to look really good when you start out. I had a client today that was like, hey, since you've started our AdWords, our clicks are down, our impressions are down, very dissatisfied with the service that we've got going on. So I said, let's jump into it. Let's see what's happening and actually take a look at the data. So number one, you have typically with AdWords Express, you're going to be running what are called automatic placements. And automatic placements are saying, Google's gonna say, hey, I'm gonna show your ad every single place that we can. That includes display ads, that includes search partner networks, and other networks that are just not relevant to your brand or your business. It's gonna be very poor quality traffic, and even times it's gonna be bot traffic. And so you're going to end up looking like you have tons of great results, but in reality, you got crap results. Now I was looking into the AdWords dashboard for the Express ads that were created, and basically 39% of the ads were being shown inside of the search network. So people typing into Google. The rest of them, which was like 71%, were then in search partner sites. So these are sites that a lot of times will have click fraud going on. It's basically if somebody has a blog or a site related, if somebody does a search in there, your results will pop up in search. It also was doing display placements for text ads, right? So if you go through and you create a text ad, it's gonna show it as a display ad. And that's not who you're targeting. If you're trying to get people to click on ads who are doing specific searches, which most people, when they think about Google AdWords, they're trying to get this traffic that is doing searches actively, then display ads are not going to be the ads that you want to do. Now, even if you're not using AdWords Express, the default click, if you just push on the guided setup and you're trying to get clicks to the website, you're going to automatically, by default, show display ads. You want to turn that off. That's not a setting that you want to do. Your brand or your business is probably not to the level of like Coca-Cola and Nike where you're doing these huge branded campaigns. You're looking to get laser targeted on your AdWords to really get transactional search terms that are people in the buying mood that want to buy and that are actively looking for a solution. So if you're a plumber, you don't want to be targeting people that say, how much does a plumber make, right? And if you did a broad match plumber search term, that would show up. Or people that says, how does plumbing work, right? They don't need a plumber right now. But if somebody's searching for the exact phrase match of emergency plumber in my town, that is probably somebody who's got water leaking into their house and they have a dire need to get a plumber over to their house right now. So there's a huge difference in intent and placement and where the searches are happening. And unfortunately, AdWords Express tries to oversimplify the whole process. So I would highly, highly suggest that you don't use AdWords Express just because it's going to really oversimplify things and not give you the control that you need. So let's talk about a few things that I think you should have set up before you start an AdWords campaign. Number one, you need to have your client personas figured out. You need to know who you're targeting. What are their pain points? What are the issues that they're trying to solve right now? What are the searches that they're performing? What's their mindset? Do they need somebody right now? Or are they just beginning searches? Or what is it that you're trying to do? Number two, you need to have an offer in mind. So knowing the pain points of these people will allow you to construct an offer. And then number three, you need to have a way for the people to take that offer. Landing pages are very, very important because it's going to give somebody a specific path to take an offer. You're telling them, hey, would you like this thing? They click on it. Yep, I want this thing. Hey, this thing looks great. I'm going to buy it. Or I'm going to book this. Or I'm going to call for a plumber. Or whatever it is that you're trying to do, right? Then you need to have the correct tracking systems in place. You need to know what it's going to cost for a conversion to happen. And you need to have a clear path to measure that. So many times people get excited and they're just like, hey, throw up some ads, let's get traffic, let's get people coming. But they're not targeting the right intent. So what ends up happening is they're starting off with a product or service that they can't measure the ROI on. They throw up ads because they're excited, and then they get traffic but no results. And then what do they say? You know what, Google Ads don't really work for me. The question I have for you though is, are you trying to target people who buy things? Because if you're trying to target people who buy things, guess who uses Google? People who buy things. You just need to be targeting the right search intent. So don't feel afraid to start out and really test and see what people are searching for and get in there with exact matches and phrase matches and really expand from that a place of getting results that are good. You can test out your ideas, and if it works, confirm the test and then start to scale instead of throwing all of your budget up and saying, I'm going to test it, I hope it works, and then guess what? It's not going to work. Google's going to take your money and you're going to be bummed. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you need help with AdWords, hey, comment below. Happy to help. Would love to know, what are you working on right now? What is your product or service? If you want, you should be sure to subscribe here. I'm actually going to be doing Funnel Fridays coming up here in the near future, where we do live streams. We're going to talk about funnels. We're going to talk and go through people's funnels. And I'm going to be reviewing different businesses and brands' funnels when on live here on YouTube. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Have a great day, everybody.